Hi everyone. Today I'm going to talk about Contessa. What does Contessa mean? Everyone, you are going to know soon. And also I'm going to focus on train, the trainer, TTM3, Cross National Perspectives, Primary Teacher Education in Cambodia. Everyone, primary teachers refers to teachers who teach students from grade 1 to grade 6 in Cambodia. Everyone, let's continue our talk together. Before talking about the whole things today, I'm going to show about you about the content that I'm going to talk first, so that everyone can follow me one by one and know for sure that what I'm going to be talking about. Everyone, number one, I'm going to talk about the geography of Cambodia. Everyone, geography refers to the location of Cambodia. And number two, I'm going to talk about the evaluation of the education system in Cambodia. Not all about the evaluation of the education system in Cambodia that I'm going to be talking about, but I'm going to talk about the important period. Number three, I'm going to talk about the basic structure of the education system in Cambodia. And number four, I'm going to talk about how to become a primary school teacher. What condition that can make you become a primary school teacher? And the last one, number five, I'm going to talk about challenges for the primary school system. Everyone, so now let's go for detail together. One, geography of Cambodia. As everyone already know, Cambodia is a country in Southeast Asia with approximately 16 million inhabitants. Inhabitant refers to the people, refers to the population. Yes, of course, there are more than 16 million populations, inhabitants in Cambodia now. And also, this Cambodia has the land area of 181,035 square kilometer. Cambodia shares border with Thailand, Laos, and also Vietnam. Thailand to the west, Laos to the north, Vietnam to the east, and how about the south? The south is the sea, of course. Everyone, the capital city and also the largest city in Cambodia is Phnom Penh. Phnom Penh is also the heart of Cambodia, the heart of the country, of course. And this country consists of 25 federal provinces. That means provinces and also the towns as well as the capital city. In total, there are 25. Cambodia is officially named the Kingdom of Cambodia and is an elective constitutional monarchy led by Norodom Sihamoni and the Prime Minister Samdech Techo Hun Sen, who has been serving since 1985 until nowadays, of course. And Cambodia has an official language. The official language is Khmer. Only one official language in this country. So this country does not have the first language or the second language, but the official language. And also the people in Cambodia learn English. English is a foreign language for Cambodian context. And number two, I'm going to talk about the evolution of the education system in Cambodia. Of course, everyone, pagodas, or we can say Buddhism, before the 20th century, long time ago, traditional education in Cambodia was handled by the local what? The bhikkhu. Bhikkhu here means the monks were the teachers. The students were almost entirely boys. Not almost, but I can say all. All were boys. Because at the pagoda, touching the monks is not allowed for the girls. That's why the girls just stay at home and the boy go to Goda in order to get education from the bhikkhus, from the man. Education was limited to memorizing Buddhist chants in Pali. Pali is a language, of course. Education involved basic literature, the foundation of religion and skill for daily life, like carpentry, artistry, craftwork, constructing, playing instrument, etc. Of course, everyone, during that time, girls were not allowed to study. That means they were not allowed to be taught by the monk. There are some reasons that the girl was not allowed to be taught by the monk. For the first thing, they were not allowed to be touched by the monk. Because during that time, the teacher had powers to fight the student, of course. That's why the monks who were the teacher can fight the student. So touching is not allowed with the girls. That's why the girl didn't go to study at the local water quota. Another reason is that the parents during that time did not allow girls to study because they were afraid that the girl were literate. The girl know how to write love letters and send to the boys. It would bring shame for the family, of course. That was the education during that time. And also, let me talk about colonial era. Of course, colonial era, we talk about the France introduced a formal education system influenced by Western educational model. I don't talk much about the French model at that time. Of course, you just know that the French ruled Cambodia for 90 years, of course, started in 1833 until 1953. Let's talk about post-independence. After our country got full independence from France by King Norodom Sihanouk, of course. I just take one point to talk about Pol Pot, of course, and Year Zero. Year Zero, of course. During Khmer Rouge regime, Khmer Rouge regime refers to the regime of Pol Pot. Education was still a severe setback, and the great strides made in literacy and education during the two decades following independence were obliterated systematically. During Pol Pot regime, there was no schools. There was no education at all. They focused on just building roads for the regime, just ditching the stream or something, of course. So the education was zero at that time. And now I'm going to talk about number three, the basic structure of the educational system in Cambodia. Everyone, the basic structure of the educational system in Cambodia, after its reform in 1996, the formal educational structure of Cambodia is formulated in 6 plus 3 plus 3. 6 here, it means 6 years at primary school from grade 1 to grade 6. And 3 refers to 3 years at lower secondary school, grade 7 to grade 9. And another 3 refers to 3 years at upper secondary school, grade 10 to grade 12. So let's look at this in more detail. This means 12 years for the completion of general education that divides up into 6 years for primary education, grade 1 to grade 3, and 6 years for secondary general education, grade 7 to 12. Secondary education consists of 3 years each for lower secondary education, grade 7 to 9, and upper secondary education, grade 10 to 12. This formulation does not include at least 1 year for preschool education, kindergarten for children from 3 to below 6 years old, and university education of 4 to 5 years, of course. 12 years, we don't talk about kindergarten because some students may enroll in grade 1, not kindergarten, but some students in kindergarten. If we talk about kindergarten, if we include kindergarten in the educational system in Cambodia, it will in total 13 years for general education, of course. And after general education, we are going to talk about tertiary education, that for bachelor degree, master degree, and PhD level course. So let's look at the figure, of course, to make sure you understand everything. Here refers to age, and here refers to grade, and here refers to education system, of course. So from 4 to 6 year, primary school or kindergarten, of course. Yes, and 6 to 12, primary education, compulsory school for all children age 6 and older. So when they are 6 years old, I mean the children, when they are 6 years old, they have to enroll at grade 1, at primary school, of course. They will study for 6 years from grade 1, grade 2, grade 3, grade 4, grade 5, and grade 6. And after that, they will finish grade 6, and from the age of 12 to 16, secondary level 1. Here from grade 7, 8, and 9, leading to a lower secondary school leaving certificate. So if they finish grade 9, they will have a degree or a certificate in trend qualification for upper secondary level. So if they finish grade 9 with a certificate, with a degree, they are eligible to register for grade 10, of course. Right, from 16 to 19, high school. High school here, it means also upper secondary school, of course, or secondary level 2 schools that prepare for higher education, of course. They will study here for 3 years too, from grade 10, 11, and 12. After that, if they pass high school exam, or we can say for another word, you say in Khmer word, we say bạc đúc. So it is high school exam, of course, baccalaureate too, of course. They will go to study at higher level, or we can say tertiary education or higher education, of course. Mainly institution of higher education. Here we start from trainings like for bachelor degree, master degree, and PhD level or PhD degree, as I talked earlier, of course. And number 5, I'm going to talk about, sorry, number 4, I'm going to talk about becoming a primary school teacher. Of course, teacher training is regulated by legislation of the federal provinces. Ministry of Education, Youth and Sport, of course. So what does it mean here? If you want to become a primary school teacher, you need to pass a grade 12 exam, or mean high school exam, and take the exam. That means another exam, of course. Exam for a teacher or for selecting teacher, of course. If you pass that exam, you will be trained for 2 years at provincial teacher training college before allowing to teach students at elementary school. Elementary school here, it means primary school. Before, after training, you will choose school according to your grade to teach. Sometimes it is far from your home, sometimes it is near your home. But nowadays, based on the reform of the Ministry of Education, Youth and Sport led by His Excellency Dr. Hong Chun-Aron, you have to choose school before starting to be trained at the Provincial Teacher Training College, of course. Number 5, I'm going to be talking about challenges for the primary school system. Yes, so even they are training for primary school teacher, but they are still lack of teaching profession. Formal teacher education cannot supply enough teachers. And another thing, we are going to talk about teaching material. The teaching material is still lack of teaching material in real practice, of course. And also, attractiveness is decreasing of the teacher profession. Despite measures taken, of course, despite measures taken like increasing salary, but the house of the teacher is far from school. So the teacher doesn't want to teach, or sometimes they want to change school or something. Another alternative teacher training pathway, lateral entrance, also teacher face major challenges too. And another thing is that heterogeneous learners at primary school, that means different kinds of learners at primary school, it is not equal or not equitable for the students to learn at primary school, of course. And also another thing is that the increasing number of children with different levels. So at primary school, there are different levels of students. It is difficult, it is hard for primary school teacher to teach the student equally or equitably, because there are different levels, different kinds of students for one class. In one class at primary school, there are 40 students or more than 40 students. So it is difficult to teach, of course. And also let me talk something a bit about during COVID-19. Teachers and students who live in the city, they can learn with new program e-learning to support their study. How about the teacher in the countryside? Some can learn, but some cannot, because they don't know anything about the technology to support their study. Even they have their smartphone, but they just know how to play games, how to watch YouTube, but they don't know how to learn using technology, using like Zoom or Skype or Google Meet or something to learn. They just use their phone to play in the wrong way or something. And the presentation of my talking has come to an end, and these are the references that I have taken the information to be talking about. And thank you so much for your attention. Thank you. Good luck. Goodbye.